Hey guys, today I have a new whole collection project pan update for you all. I'm really excited to roll some of these things out and to roll in some new items as well. I've been working on this stuff for what feels like forever, so I'm definitely ready for some new stuff, but let's just get right into it. If you guys haven't been watching this series, I roll everything out once I hit 30 uses. Or if there is a pan, if I hit pan first, then it can go out as well. So let's just hop in. I'm gonna go in order of how they are written down on my little notebook. So I'm not gonna do like everything that's rolling out just at the beginning. I'm just gonna go in order. But that being said, first I have my ABH Beverly Hills Blush Trio in Peachy Love, and I'm working on the shade Nectarine. And this is what it's looked like before. And this is what it's looking like today. So it's this shade here, but I've been using pretty much all of the shades. I've been mixing and matching, but always at least using this shade. And I did finally hit my 30 use goal. Previously I had 16 uses. So I used it an additional, 14 more times to get my 30 use goal, and this is what it looks like. I will have close-ups of everything as we go along, but it basically looks the same. There's just some brush strokes in it, but yeah, I'm ready to roll this one out. It's really pretty. I do really like these ones, but I've had this out for a while, so I'm ready to be focusing on something else. The next product is another blush, actually, and this is the MAC and Caitlyn Jenner blush in the shade Buddy, and this is what it looked like last time. And here is what it is currently looking like today. It looks probably exactly the same. I don't really see any brush strokes or any visible progress or anything, and we probably won't because this is very hardly pressed. I just swirled the like glowy part and the matte part together, and previously we only had used this one time, and now we are at 7 uses. So we did use this 6 more times this month. It took me a while to finish off the ABH blush, and then I kind of was playing around a little bit as well as using this one, but this will now be my main focus blush. I do want to play around a little bit with my Shop My Stash and Project 5 uses, but mostly I will be working on this guy. Next, we have my OPV Beauty Spotlight Palette. And we were working on the shade Dream, which is the bright blue color. So this is what it looked like previously. And here is what it's looking like today. It is this shade right up here. There's a little bit of wear and tear in there, but not too much. I kind of was just using it right where the lettering is, so the lettering's like a little blurred now, but not too much of a noticeable difference. I wore this on the lower lash line like every single time I was using it, and I think I did wear this in the crease a few times as well, like blown out when I was doing a blue look. But I did reach my 30 use goal on this guy this month. So previously we had used it 16 times. So again, we had to use this, 14 more times to hit our 30 use goal. But this guy will be rolling out now. Next, we have my AOA Studio Liquid Lipstick in the shade Faded. So this has been in for a few months now as well, and I can't really show any progress. I've tried to shine a light through it to see if I've seen any change, and I can't really see anything. Right now when I'm looking through it, I see like a little bit of like breakage down to here. like where, so when it's looking in the mirror, so I think it's like about down to here, which is pretty good progress. I'm not going to mark it or anything, just because there's no way I'm going to use this up with 30 uses. So, we're just going to leave it be how it is. So previously we had used this 8 times and now we are at 18 times. So we use this 10 more times this month. And I'm just going to keep slowly working on this. I was using this quite a bit at the beginning of the update, or the beginning of the month. And then I kind of switched over to focusing on something else, but I think I need to get back into using this and finishing this one for next update. And next we have from Elginus. This is my Reveal Drops in the shade Rosé. And this one will also be rolling out this update. This is the last product that's rolling out. So we have 3 rollouts this month. And previously we had used this 27 times. So I only had to use this 3 more times this update. At the beginning, this is pretty dried out, first of all. So it does come in a dropper packaging, but I can't like drop anything. I just use what's on the sides of the dropper, wipe it on the back of my hand, and then go in with a brush. But when I put this in, I think we were around the like 5, like, so like this line here. And now I am seeing like, it doesn't really settle because it's pretty thick, but I'm seeing like scraping marks down here by like the 3. Can you guys see that? So we've made quite a bit of progress. I don't think there's a lot left in here. This is something that I'm considering panning completely next year. So stay tuned. Excuse me. Stay tuned. This will probably be in a project next year to try to finish it off. Okay, we have really good progress on the rest of this stuff. The rest of this was all rolled in last update, but first we have my e.l.f. bronzer. So this is what it looked like last month. So you can see it was basically like pretty much new. This is what it's looking like now. So you can tell definitely that I've used it. There's tons of like disturbance. Not really a dip or anything, but I have erased the like e.l.f. Logo, I guess, that was pressed on here. I have used this 5, 10, 15, 20 times. So I only have to use this 10 more times. I won't be able to hit pan in 20 uses, but I am happy that I was able to get quite a bit of use on this guy. I did switch this over into my highlighter category. So even though it does say it's a bronzer, this is definitely a highlighter. I'll swatch everything that's staying in the project. I'll have to go back and swatch the other stuff. But here is that e.l.f. bronzer. So it's definitely just like a deeper highlight. I've been mixing this with the other highlighter that's in this project that we'll talk about in a minute. But I did officially switch this in my spreadsheet from a bronzer to a highlighter category. So that is what this looks like. Let me swatch out the Caitlyn Jenner and MAC blush. Here is that right there underneath. And then the AOA liquid lipstick, I guess we'll do just a little dot because this will dry down. So there is that right there. It is very nude. So I've been mixing this with a more warm toned liquid lipstick. So there are those 3 that we've talked about already. Okay, the next item that will also be staying in is from Fiona Styles, and this is my eyeshadow, Artist Eyeshadow Quad in Electra. And I'm working on, there's a name, but I'm working on the purple shade in here. So this is what it looked like last update. And this is what it's looking like now. So it is this darker purple up here in the corner. You can see there's a little disturbance, maybe a little bit of a dip. I've been wearing this on the lower lash line pretty much every single day. I did fluff this out into the outer corner in the crease a few times as well, but mainly I've been working on this on the lower lash line. I'm at 25 uses on this, guys, so this will definitely be rolled out next time. I only have to wear it 5 more times. There's no way I'll hit pan, but there is that shade right there. It's really pretty on the lower lash line, and that's how I've really been liking using it. Like I did say, I did wear it out in the crease a few times. Next, we have my lip liner, and this is the Palladio Lip Liner in Nutmeg, and I have used this 5, 6, 7, 8 times since I rolled it in last time, so we still got a ways to go on this, but I do really like this. I just kind of switched focus over to the lip liner I'm trying to completely finish by the end of the year, which I don't really know if I'm going to be able to do or not, but there is that color right there. What I've been doing is, well, at one point, what I was doing was this lip liner and then mixing those two, that liquid lipstick with this one from my rolling project pan. I've been mixing those all together or layering those together. And I really did like that color. So that is probably what I will go back to at the start of this coming update. Like I said, I have 8 uses on that guy currently, and we'll keep working on him, but right here is it on the paper. I did any pencil products I will mark on the paper, but there's that tiny, tiny, tiny little progress line at the very top, but I don't really see myself using too much of this pencil. It is pretty dense. It's not super creamy, but we're just gonna keep going with it. 2 more products, and then we can roll in 3 more items. First, we have my Blink Glow Getter Face Palette, and we are working on a highlighter in here in the shade Empowered. So this is what it looked like when I rolled it in last month. And last month, it was brand new. I had just gotten this in my BoxyCharm. And this is the shade that we are working on, Empowered. So that's what it's looking like now. Definitely some nice like brush strokes and disturbance in there. And I am very happy to have this out and playing with it as soon as I got it, because a lot of times it has to sit in my little box of new products for a while before I can reach for it. So I am excited to have this guy out and playing with it. I have already used it 20 times, so we're close. I've been mixing the e.l.f. highlighter with this highlighter every single day. That way I'm getting use out of both shades. And this also helps tone down the e.l.f. highlighter. It's right here. And making it more of a wearable shade for me since I am not super tan anymore. This one is a little too dark. But I'm excited to have this out and to continue playing with it. Next, and last, we have my Too Faced Cocoa Contour palette, and we were working on the shade Medium Mocha, and this is what it looked like when we rolled it in. And here is what it's looking like today. It is this shade down here. This is what it's looking like. Not really a dip or anything. If you look super, super close, I don't know if you guys will be able to see, but this pan in general looks a lot lower than the other 3. I think because I did have some previous usage on this as well, and that's really the only shade I've reached for in this palette. But we did use this 20 times already this month, so it's gotten quite a bit of love, and this will hopefully be rolled out for next time as well. I guess we should swatch it. There it is right there on the bottom, just a nice bronzer color. And that's everything that's currently in my project. So for goals from this grouping of items, I have 10 uses left on this bronzer. It's gonna be done. I have 10 uses on both of these highlighters. These should both be done. I have 5 uses left on the eyeshadow. This will definitely be done. And then I really wanna work on this liquid lipstick. It has 5, 10, 15, 16, 17, 18 uses. So that's what, 12 more uses. I think I can do it, and I want to get this one done. But excuse me. These two are still gonna be in here for a while, I think. But that being said, let's roll in some new items. So we are rolling out three, which means we get to roll in three more. Okay, I have my Pretty Random app up and my computer off to the side. So minimum zero, max is 3,555 items. This is every single piece of makeup I own. Eyeshadow is all individually listed. It's a lot, I know it's a lot, but it is what it is. So let's just go ahead and roll. Oh, is there anything we cannot use? Yes, since I did switch this over into my spreadsheet as a highlighter, I will not be rolling in another powdered highlighter because I have two. My max is only two of each item. But that's it. I have one eyeshadow, so once we roll in one more eyeshadow, we won't roll another. I have most of my collection is eyeshadow, so I will most likely get an eyeshadow. Everything else is fair game for at least one item. Anyway, okay, let's just go. Let's just go do it. Ooh, an older product, 172. Let's see what that is. What is it? What is it? What is it? Okay, interesting. We will do it though. Oh, it's not the one I was thinking it was. Okay. So this is a Kylie Cosmetics eye base in the shade Camo. Previously, I had in the Kylie Cosmetics cream eyeshadow in yellow gold. And this is kind of a similar color. That'll be interesting. I'm excited about that. I thought it was the one that's above it, the shade Snow. That's like a matte white, but it's not. It's like a yellowy greenish color. And since that's a cream eyeshadow, it's not gonna count as my like powder eyeshadow of max of two. Okay, 972. Okay. We got the NYX Lingerie Liquid Lipstick in the shade Exotic. I don't know what shade that is. I have a ton of those. There's a whole bunch of nudes and some darker colors. That will be the max for liquid lipsticks. Exciting one. This is the last one. 1341. Okay. That's a big mama. This is a powdered eyeshadow, and this comes from my Simply Pleasures eyeshadow palette, and it's shade 94. This is my 100 pan palette. I was wondering when this was gonna get rolled into a project again. Depending on the color, I have a chance of hitting pan on this pretty quickly. So let me go pull out all of these products and I'll be right back. Okay, we are back. So let's go through the products. They're gonna be a little hard, but it'll be okay. So first we rolled in the Kylie Cosmetics cream eyeshadow in Camo. This is what it looks like. So it's like a darker version of the yellow gold shade that I was working on previously. In this project, but that is what it looks like. There's a little bit of a dip, not too much. Again, I will have close-ups. It's still pretty creamy. It's a little bit dry, but it's pretty creamy still. And that is what it looks like. So it is dark. I don't know how I'm gonna use this. I might just wear this as a lower lash line shade. I feel like it would be really pretty, like as a liner. And it's a little dark for me for a base. I don't know. There's definitely like the greenish kind of mossy undertone. And then it does have those gold glitters. It's pretty. It's definitely like one of those like ugly pretty colors. You know what I mean? Where it's like blah and boring and ugly looking, but it's gonna be pretty on the eyes. So I'm excited to play with this guy. It hasn't gotten enough love from me in my collection, like at all. So I'm excited to play with that one. And then next we have a NYX liquid lipstick in the shade Exotic. These all came in an advent calendar a while ago. I mean, we'll see if this is too dry or not, but oh, it works good. This is the shade Exotic. It's just a little mini guy. It's pretty dark. It's not too dark though. At first I was thinking it was gonna be like really red, but it's not too bad. Those are like really pretty like holiday shades, I feel like. So we'll see what we can do on this guy. It's gonna be hard to wear like on the everyday basis, but we'll see what we can do. Okay, and then the big kahuna. This is my Simply Pleasures 100 pan eyeshadow palette. I haven't counted it out yet, but we're looking at shade 94. I do already have pan on this shade, and it was pretty easy to hit pan on. Okay, let's count them out. I'll be right back, because last time I counted it out and it was the wrong shade, so we're gonna count. Ooh, okay. This is the shade we got. It's like a dark navy blue. Interesting. Interesting choice there. So, there, that is swatched out. Not the most pigmented, but it's definitely buildable. This will be a liner shade for me, and I'll probably be able to hit pan on this pretty easy as a liner. These pans are pretty shallow, so that should be an easy one. It should be an easy one. I'm currently working on one shade as a liner that I really want to hit pan on, but maybe I'll switch over to this one first because that one's not in a project. It's just like a personal goal. but I think I'll probably switch to this one, hit pan on it, and then go back. But I should be able to hit pan on this relatively easy. If you guys can see this in the brown shade, the pans are not very deep at all. Honestly, I'm thinking like maybe like 10 uses and I should be able to hit pan, especially like if I'm using it as an eyeliner that tends to like dig it down more. Yeah, that should be a good one. That should be a pretty good one. Okay, that is everything for today's update. I'm excited to have some new things to play around with. And yeah, hopefully I should have a lot of progress next update. But that is going to be everything for this update. I hope you guys like this video. And definitely like, comment, and subscribe down below for more. And I'll talk to you in the next one. Bye, guys.